So like most people these days, you probably used a Snapchat filter, Instagram filter, or probably played Pokemon Go at some point. All of those three things that I mentioned are a version of augmented reality or virtual reality, and it's changing the way that marketing happens, the way that consumers engage with products and services even before they make a purchase, and then even, you know, pushing them towards making that actual sale. In today's video, I'm gonna explain the benefits of augmented reality, where I see it going with regards to marketing and how you can use it to benefit on your marketing campaign. So stay tuned, here we go. Welcome back, everybody. My name is Jordan Steen, also known as Serial Entrepreneur. And at this channel, we talk all about starting a marketing agency, building a personal brand online, or really just building any kind of online business. So if you're interested in learning about any of those topics I just mentioned, then make sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell right here in the bottom right hand corner. Well, really, right down there. And that way you'll get subscribed to all of our future videos, our templates, our guides, our giveaways that we do every single week here at my channel. So companies all over the world, especially large corporations, they're starting to implement augmented reality into their platforms, into their day-to-day business, how they market to customers. And that is something that you're gonna have to pay attention to. Why? Because people want to experience something without even having to go into the store. And that's what augmented reality allows you to do. So like I mentioned in the beginning, we're gonna talk about a couple platforms that are already using augmented reality for their customers or for their audience, and some other companies you might not even be aware of and how they're using it to affect their marketing. P.S. Make sure to stay tuned to the end of the video where we'll teach you guys how we're using Snapchat to build our brand online. So to start, Snapchat actually released something called Shoppable AR, which actually allows people to use a specific kind of lens and a couple of software features within Snapchat to try out products and services that a brand might offer. Now, this is really only available for larger brands right now, but it is going to be a feature that they release to smaller and medium-sized businesses as well. The reason why I keep talking about Snapchat is because they're really the best company that's out there doing it. They're not the only, you know, social platform that's out there with augmented reality, but they've made it to where it's more organic to use augmented reality versus a lot of the other platforms where it may seem a little forced. So since we're talking about other businesses that do or have augmented reality features, Instagram is obviously one due to the filters that they have and the specific, you know, software integrations that they have with their app. But also Facebook has something called AR Studio, which is going to allow you to incorporate augmented reality into your camera experiences for your brands on Facebook, not only on the feed, but in things like Messenger and Stories and all over the place. So it's going to be a super important feature to, you know, be aware of and to be able to implement into your campaigns. So let's go into four different types of experiences that are definitely going to be super huge in the future, and you're going to want to, again, incorporate into your plan. The first one is going to be virtual AR stores, which are essentially where you take augmented reality and build an online store where people can test products and services. So let me give you a good example. Say an online retailer, like a clothing retailer, wants you to be able to try on a t-shirt and see how it looks on you before you actually purchase the t-shirt. You'll have features where you can actually upload an image, can even be a 3D image of yourself, and try on the t-shirt before you even go into the store. So that way you know what it looks like and how, you know, you can actually make a decision without even leaving your home on whether you like that t-shirt or not. The second one is going to be AR live events. So for example, say there's a concert going on, you know, across the country that you definitely can't make it to, but you really want to experience that live concert. Well, with AR for live events, you're actually going to be able to sit at home and watch one of those concerts, and it'll feel like you're actually at the concert. Why? Because of things like advancements in TVs, in software, in stereo equipment and audio equipment, you're actually able to almost feel like you're at that experience happening right now. The third thing could be something like AR video. And this is where companies are going to use augmented reality to do, for example, walkthroughs on their products or services and show their customers the best ways to use it. So for example, I just bought this gimbal. It's over here somewhere. It's a gimbal for my camera. One of the hardest things to do with that gimbal is get it to balance. So it would be really, really cool if they had an augmented reality feature where I could just go on and actually see how they're doing it and get a 360 view of everything that's happening. The fourth thing is to create AR experiences that are really, really shareable. Okay, quote unquote shareable. And what that means is you're going to do cool filters. For example, the little hot dog filter on Snapchat got super freaking popular once it came out because it was just a little dancing hot dog. It's silly, but those kinds of things are things that people will share with their friends to get them engaged on that platform, right? So if you create a really cool filter or lens, as they're referred to as, if you create something really cool and engaging for your brand, let's say for a car dealership, they made like a cool, you know, truck AR graphic or image, whatever they wanted to use for that that dealership. But if they did something like that and you could actually go inside and play around with the truck and mess with all the features, that would be a really cool shopping experience for someone looking to buy a vehicle, right? So all of these things that are going on, and there's going to be more changes, more updates in the future because technology just keeps getting advanced and more things are possible just because of the advancements that we're seeing. So guys, I strongly recommend you start looking at AR and virtual reality and how we can incorporate it even more into our campaigns for our clients, for our own businesses, for our own brands, because it is going to be the future, or one of the future pieces of marketing that really, really matter. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. And at the beginning, I did mention that I would teach you guys some tricks that we've used to grow our Snapchat. The biggest thing that I can say that we have done to grow our Snapchat is to ask people questions. We don't just post content about our products and services. We try to come up with posts and stories that are gonna make people send a message back to me. And the reason why we do that is because we know if we can get them to message me, number one, it opens up conversation, but number two, now they get to feel like they're actually meeting with the person or the brand or the product that they really want to engage with, right? So don't actually use your Snapchat account if you're just sitting there and you're sending one word answers back, or you're just posting about products and services and that's it. People want to use Snapchat like it's with their friends. So really consider Snapchat as a friend to friend interaction, right? And that's how you want to use it with your business. Don't look at it as trying to sell products and services only. Use it to get information, use it for customer support. We use it to get chats from people. We tell people to message us there. So that way, number one, we're adding them on Snapchat. But number two, it's getting them to know, hey, if they ever need to shoot us just a quick message, they can reach out there and get an answer very quickly. But that's really it for growing your Snapchat. It's really not that hard. It's a platform that's still rather new. The ad platform isn't the best yet because the cost per click or the cost per viewer or impression is super, super high. So I don't recommend doing it, you know, as your primary mode of influencing your audience, unless you're someone like Kim Kardashian. It's gonna be very hard for you to do. But Snapchat is super useful. It is a great platform to communicate with your audience. Use it as a communication channel rather than a marketing platform directly. But that's it, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you guys on the next video. Make sure that you hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our contents, updates, free trainings, giveaways, everything that we do here at my channel. But I'm gonna get out of here and I will see you guys on the next video. Until then, Serial Entrepreneur out. Bye guys.
Ready to start living the six-figure, work wherever, be your own boss lifestyle? Well, at Serial Entrepreneur Academy, we'll teach you how to use a laptop and internet to start your own social media and digital marketing agency. Get started with our free Facebook ads training. Links in the description below, guys. See you in the course. Serial Entrepreneur out.